Thank you. Very good afternoon and welcome to Sport Singapore's live coverage of the 2021 National School Games. We are live from Nan Chiau High School. This is the A Division Girls Table Tennis quarterfinal. On court, we are seeing Anderson's Serangoon Junior College versus Hwa Chong Institution. That's Anderson Serangoon JC versus Hwa Chong Institution. This is the first doubles, the first singles we showcased earlier. Hwa Chong's Eloise Tan winning 3-0. She beat a Hui 11-5, 11-6, 11-3. So now in this first doubles fixture, we see HCI or Hwa Chong in red, the traditional colors. Hwa Chong are represented by Lucia, who is now on serve, together with her partner Yi Xuan. So it's Yi Xuan and Lucia for Hwa Chong Institution. Meanwhile, for Anderson Serangoon Junior College, it's Yung Teng and Kathy. Kathy is now serving. It's back to Lucia. This is only the first set in the first doubles this afternoon. There are six teams in the quarterfinal stage, and the six teams are playing round robin. And at the end of the round robin quarterfinal stage, the top four from the six will advance to the semifinals. So if you win an encounter, you secure 2 points. The losing team will take home 1 point. So at the end of the round robin stage, the points will be tabulated. Top four will advance to the last four. Still Lucia. I beg your pardon, that was Kathy serving for Anderson Serangoon. It's back to Lucia to serve for Hwa Chong. So far in the first set, I think both teams are taking it easy. Nobody has really gone for any spectacular or killer attack moves. The points are just secured within after a matter of about 2 or 3 exchanges with Hwa Chong at set point. And the set was won by Yi Xuan and Lucia from Hwa Chong Institution. They've set the stage and the tone for this first doubles. Let's see what they're made of when we come back in 1 minute. And we are about to start the second set of this first doubles. This time it would be Anderson Serangoon to serve. Again, it's Kathy doing the honors. So So Anderson just lost first set, 6-11. They've also lost the first fixture, 3-0. But this being the quarterfinals, organizers are allowing all five teams to play. That means the three singles and the two doubles. So even if one school goes on to win 3-0, the first three, they will still play out the second doubles and the third singles. But once you advance into the semifinals, it's the first to reach 3 points wins it. So this afternoon, we are in for an exciting campaign as we'll see all the players, close to 9 of them, all in action. 7 of them, I beg your pardon, from each school. 3 singles, 2 doubles. Anderson Serangoon told to give the possession away, service possession. The Hua Chong teammates, as you can see in the background, applauding their teammates. And interesting to see the Hua Chong team, they were down by 2 and they've come back, equalized, taken the lead. Oh, given away that 1 point through Yi Xuan with that rather strong return. So it's Ng Yi Xuan serving for Hua Chong Institution. Oh, the umpire is not happy with that one. That gives the team in green a bit of time to breathe and equalize and try and win this much-needed second set. They're still trailing. They've lost the first, 6-11. They're still fighting hard, 7-8 now, Anderson. This is Lucia to serve. Ooh, good attack by Yi Xuan. I think that's the first real attack for in this second set. And it is a set point again for Hua Chong. Is faulted her for the service. So it's 10-9. And it's that's a wrap for this second set as well. So Anderson Serangoon lost the first set, 6-11. They came back strong, and the duo of Yang Teng and Cathy have cut the deficit down to 9-11. So overall, they trailed this doubles fixture 2-0. So you're watching the website go.gov.sg/nsg. That's where you can go to catch all your live streams, the schedules of the live stream matches and highlights from the rest of the other sports like shooting, bowling, taekwondo, wushu, and some of the other sports that have been covering this past 4 weeks. So that's go.gov.sg/nsg. So we're back with the third set of the first doubles between Anderson Serangoon JC in orange and Hwa Chong Institution in their preferred red tops. The Anderson Serangoon duo of Ying Teng and Cathy in a way rushing their shots, especially when upon receive. If they can only keep their shots on target, they will be in for a good fight in this first doubles. But at the moment, it is those little mistakes like that that has allowed their opponents to run away with a 3-point margin. That was a really good rally. I think the longest so far in this fixture. Fortunate for Cathy, who puts it into the net. So it's a 4-point deficit for Anderson Serangoon. The Hwa Chong duo of Yixuan and Lucia appear to be more composed, more lethal in their attacks, more clinical in their finishing. So it's Cathy to serve. There for the pair in orange. Ying Teng serve. This is a match point, Hwa Chong Institution. So Hwa Chong Institution doing a brilliant job wrapping up the third set 11-5. So they won the first 11-6. In the second, they triumphed 11-9. In the third, they won it 11-5. So that effectively, in the overall scheme of things, means Hwa Chong Institution win the first singles, first doubles, so they lead this afternoon 2-0. So what's in store for the second singles? We'll find out in 5 minutes. You're watching Sports Singapore's live coverage of the 2021 National School Games. We are live from Nan Chiau High as we are watching A Division Girls Quarterfinals action in table tennis. On court is Hwa Chong Institution versus Anderson Serangoon Junior College. Anderson Serangoon represented by Yen Sien in the orange top. You just see her now, she's about to serve. HCI are represented by Sun Ihan. So, Ihan is in the traditional red colors of Hwa Chong Institution. So in the blink of an eye, Zihan from Hwa Chong is leading by four. It's been almost the same momentum this afternoon. All going the way of Hwa Chong Institution. They won the first singles 3-0. They won the first doubles 3-0. Both convincing fashions. Now this is the first set of the second singles. If they go on to win this, we will still go on to see the second doubles and the third singles, because this is still the quarterfinal stage. The organizers are allowing all the students who have trained to still go and compete and represent the schools. Even though Hwa Chong might have won 3-0, but we'll still see the second doubles and third singles. But when it comes to the semifinals and finals, it's a different story altogether. So it's set point for Zihan. It's 3-11. Somehow the team from Anderson Serangoon JC collectively are struggling to find any form of resistance against this well-oiled team from Hwa Chong Institution. We'll be back in 1 minute. So we are back with the second set. Just a reminder that how this table tennis format works is there are six teams competing in the quarterfinals. All six teams are playing in a round robin format. So each team will get to play five matches against their respective opponents. And for each win is 2 points. Each loss is a single point. At the end of the quarterfinal stage, the top four will advance to the semifinals. That's how they are operating in this quarterfinals format for table tennis. Once again, Sihan is already racing to a big lead over her Anderson Serangoon JC opponent. So Yen Sien, sir. good play by Sihan. She managed to, the ball managed to just touch the edge of the table before flying out. As you can see, it's a series of just easy touches. No killer attacks or fancy stunts. Up at 9-2. It's second singles. Second set in the second singles. Set point for Sihan. And this was a much more convincing win for the Hua Chong student. She won 11-3 in the first, and she has just taken the second set 11-2. Very good performance by Sun Sihan, and we'll see her in just one more minute. So it's Anderson to serve in this third set of the second singles. Yen Xian serve. She's already been faulted for that service. And Sihan is already off and running, 2-0 lead. Yen Xian serving again. It's she. Somehow she seems to be giving away a few points. And which I think she can actually save those points if she was just being a bit more accurate. But at the moment, she's 6 points down. Sihan making a rare mistake. Again, she's been faulted for the service. I think the umpire says your hand is below the table. So she's lost 2 points during the serve. Match point, Hua Chong Institution. And that's it. This is a very good performance, a very strong performance by Sihan from HCI. As she beat Yen Xian 11-3, first set, 11-2, second set, 11-2 again in the third set. A very, very commanding performance by Sihan, which means in the overall scheme of things, Hua Chong Institution have already won this fixture because they've won three straight. They've won the first singles, the first doubles, and the second singles. So that's a confirmation, 3-3-3. I think this is a number that's, you don't really see this happening too often in the NSG, but it's happened this afternoon. So we'll still come back with the second doubles and the third singles. We'll be back in 5 minutes. You're watching Sports Singapore's live coverage of the 2021 National School Games. We are live from Nan Chiau High for this afternoon's A Division Girls Table Tennis Quarterfinals. This is one of 12 to 14 quarterfinals that's ongoing over the next 1 week. And on court right now, you see Anderson Serangoon Junior College in orange versus their opponents from Hwa Chong Institution. Their favorite colors of red. This is the second doubles this afternoon. HCI, Hwa Chong Institution, are represented by Glenda Teo and Yang Chun Si, while Harini and Tzu Ying are for Anderson Serangoon JC. Hwa Chong lead 3-0, having won the first singles, the first doubles, and the second singles. And they've done it in spectacular fashion with 3-0 victories in all three fixtures. So there's the fourth fixture this afternoon. Let's see if Anderson Serangoon can try and at least win one of the fixtures. There are five per school, three singles, two doubles. It's Glenda to serve for Hwa Chong. Now it's Tzu Ying serving. Anderson Serangoon haven't won a single set all afternoon. Let's see if they can go on to win at least this first set in the second doubles. She went for the attack, good attack by Singh, but fortunately hit her own net. Glenda serve. Mistake by Harini there. Hwa Chong girls have caught up. They were down 2 points early, or 3 points. The umpire has called to serve again. And both teams level. Net play. Some of the applause that you hear is also from the other side of the hall, which the boys' quarterfinals are ongoing. So two matches being played in the same indoor sports hall. It's Hwa Chong with a 1-point lead. Set point, Hwa Chong Institution. Glenda, serve. And it's unfortunate there for Anderson Serangoon Junior College. Just when you thought they could go on to win at least their first set, they were leading by 3 points at one stage. Unfortunately, mistakes allowed Glenda and Chin Si to come back. And again, they've won the first set. Hwa Chong Institution. We'll be back in 1 minute. About to start the second set of the second doubles. Can the team in orange from Anderson Serangoon Junior College, Harini and Tzu Ying, can they at least win one set for the school? Because their earlier teammates couldn't get the job done. All went down fighting 3-0, 3-0, 3-0. So even though Anderson Serangoon have already lost this particular fixture, still not over yet, because they're playing a points table system. So if they can win one or two sets, you never know. That might come in crucial when it comes to when the points are tabulated at the end of the quarterfinal series and teams are level. If the teams are level on points, then they'll see sets. They'll take into account the sets won. So every set is important. Harini, serve. Got a warning on the serve. I really couldn't believe the shot came ricocheted off her bat and went out. See, the points are just within 5 to less than 10 seconds of gameplay. Point is earned, point is lost. Blender, sir. Unfortunate there for Tzu Ying. She couldn't return that. Nice attack by Glenda to take it to 9-4. The teammate Chun Si knew that she made a mistake. That's why she reacted with her arms in the air. Oh, that was unfortunate. It's a set point for Hwa Chong. Oh no. What? It's 11-5 going the way of Hwa Chong Institution. Because I think Anderson Serangoon, the duo, made a few critical mistakes to give away that second set, in my opinion, too easily. So will they go down 3-0? We'll find out in just a minute. We're back for the start of the third set in the second doubles. Harini and Tsu Ying serve. They're trailing 2-0. They lost 8-11, 5-11. Nope, Glenda's been called for net. So just got to reserve the point. Once. Vincent Rangoon finally on the board for three consecutive points. Running away in the third set, the Hua Chong duo. Seven, 7-1. There seems to be no stopping this team from Hua Chong. This pair, and including all their earlier players in the singles and the two singles matches and the first doubles. Glenda, sir. That is a match point. Watch on institution. Tsu Ying. So, Harini went for the attack. Unfortunately, the game has come to an end. And those are your winners, Glenda Teo and Young Chun Si from Hua Chong Institution, winning the first set 11-8, second set 11-5, and the third set even higher, 11-3. So collectively, as we wait for, you'll see the final tabulation in a minute, where after four matches, it is 3-0. You already know that Hua Chong Institution have already won 2 points for this entire fixture. But look at the... this is a devastating defeat for Anderson Serangoon Junior College. But we'll still come back for the third singles in 5 minutes. Very good afternoon and welcome back to Sports Singapore's live coverage of the 2021 National School Games. We are live from Nan Chiau High as we are watching the A Division Girls Table Tennis quarterfinals. In orange, you'd see Kai Lin representing Anderson Serangoon Junior College, while Sarah Ang is in the colors of Hwa Chong Institution. This is the third singles. It is the fifth and final fixture this afternoon. After two singles and two doubles matches, Hwa Chong lead 4-0. That's right, 4-0, because they won all four matches 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0. So, effectively, they've won the fixture and they secured 2 points because of the fact that this is a based on a points table system. At the end of the quarterfinal tournament next week, they'll tabulate the results from the round-robin format, and only four teams out of the six that are playing in this quarterfinals will go to the will advance to the semifinals. So Anderson Serangoon might have lost today, but they still have everything to play for in their next few matches, including possibly winning one or two sets, because they haven't won this afternoon. So the sets might come in handy when teams are drawn and level on points at the end of the tournament. At the moment, it's all Sarah Ang's way. She's leading 3-1. That's a brave and attacking move from Kai Lin. We've seen very few attacking moves from the entire Anderson Serangoon team. But Kai Lin could certainly turn this match around and prevent a clean sweep of 5-0. Let's see what Kai Lin can do. She's trailing at the moment. But another one of those attacking moves, unfortunately, this time didn't go her way. She served. Opponent Sarah is just calm, cool, composed on the other side of the table. Nope. Still 2-7. Reserve. Still a net. Reserve again. That's the third time the umpire has called for Kai Lin to reserve. And she wins that point. Sarah, serve. Fortunate there for Kai Lin, she puts it straight to the net. Good attacking move by Sarah, puts her in on set point. Sarah takes the first set in this fifth fixture, third singles, 11-3. So great start by the student from Hwa Chong Institution. We'll be back in 60 seconds. Just about to start the second set. third singles. Sarah Ang, Hwa Chong Institution, won the first set 11-3. She serves. That was uncharacteristic of Sarah based on her gameplay in the first set. So, first point goes to Kailin. Nice one by Kailin. But it's her opponent who wins the point. As you can see, Kailin, among all of her teammates, I think she's the one who's displaying the most aggression in her attacking moves. So hopefully in their next few matches, Anderson, Serangoon, the rest of the team can sort of take a leaf off the gameplay of Kailin and adopt a slightly more attacking strategy in the rest of their matches, if they're harboring any hopes of reaching the semi-final. As for today, they know that they were up against a powerhouse in Hwa Chong, so the teams did the best that they could. As Kailin now finds herself down 5 points. She's back on serve. What can Kailin do? Oh, nap. Blink of an eye, it's set point again for Hwa Chong Institution. That's it, 11-2. So, Sarah Ang won the first set 11-3. She's done one better, 11-2 in the second set. Just when we thought Kailin from Anderson Serangoon could mount a comeback, it still seems the way of HCI. We'll be back in 1 minute to see whether they complete a complete 5-0 route. Back in 60. We're back with the third set in third singles. Sarah Ang, as you can see, leads 2-0. She goes on to win this. Everybody goes home with Hwa Chong Institution going home with having won all 5 matches. So that's a complete sweep, 5-0. Plus the fact that they didn't drop a single set. That's the distinction that they have. So, can Kailin try and prevent that by at least taking one set home for Anderson Serangoon? I'm sure some of you watching at home are probably hoping for that. So it's Kailin serve. Still very close, only 1 point. Oh dear. Kailin needs to just focus. It's another point given away again.
Okay.
What? Sarah mistimed that one badly. And she's just taking a second, because you know that the hall is humid, hot and humid. All the fans are switched off. Good play by Kailin, but impact was just too strong. She's got a chance to make amends now on the serve. Okay, she wins 1 point. Oh, that is brings us to match point for Sarah and Hwa Chong Institution. And that's a wrap, 11-5. So another fantastic performance by Hwa Chong Institution. Sarah Ang winning the first set 11-3, second set 11-2. Third set, 11-5. So she wins this one to give Hwa Chong a fantastic result overall. As you can see, this overall table, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0. And overall, they take home a 5-0 route. So a stupendous performance by the team from Hwa Chong Institution. They pick up 2 points for today's win, while Anderson still take home 1 point. It's not over yet, because these two teams will go and play on other opponents in the round-robin format at the end of the quarterfinals in next week, and they'll tabulate the points and see the top four teams going through to the semifinals. There are 6 teams currently competing. 4 will go through the semifinals. You never know. Anderson, Serangoon, JC might still make it to the last 4. In the meantime, I'm Raj Kumar, and we'll be back at 4 o'clock for our next match. So join us again on go.gov.sg/NSG. That's go.gov.sg/NSG for the next quarterfinal match coming up at 4 p.m. Bye for now.